But they really haven't changed how they play, but it's just different personnel. And he's Castleton's a really, really good player, one of the top bigs in the country. And, you know, you could tell they were a little uncomfortable playing against the last two games, but I'm sure they'll be ready to play against us. But they really haven't changed how they've been playing, what we've seen on film.
Yeah, does the game plan with how you want to utilize Oscar, does that shift at all likewise for you?
No, I don't think so. I think we'll still have the same game plan, what we want to do. Like I said, they're playing the same coverage that they've been playing with those other two guys.
How usable is the film from the last game just because Castleton is such a big part of what they
do? It's a little tricky. It's a little different. We've definitely watched. And there's some things we can still do. But, I mean, he's so good on both ends of the floor. It does change some things for us.
Have Sabir and CJ gotten back to practice yet? And what's it looking
like? We haven't practiced today yet. And they're working hard every day to get back. Just work severe out an individual workout. So we'll see. We don't know yet.
How key is it going to be to get maybe just one or two of those guys back to help with the backcourt depth?
We can just get one of them. I mean, it'd be great if we get two. It'd be even better. But those guys bring so much. Just with their play and their experience and their basketball IQ, we can definitely use either one of those guys. We would love to have both of them and can't wait to get them back. Really good. I mean, a dude's going to be a really good player in the future, but he's done a heck of a job helping us out, being able to play the point and play different positions. He attacks the rim really well. He's one of the top guys in the country at getting fouled for the minutes he plays. Defensively, he gets a lot of blocks for a guard. So he's helped a lot, and he's learning and getting better every game just with playing.
Kyle talked a couple of weeks about challenging Oscar to improve on the defensive end. It looks like the Boston defense has been a little better. What have you seen?
Coaches just really challenged him to guard better in ball screens and communicate better, and he's took it upon himself to accept the challenge, and he's doing a lot better, like you said. I mean, he's engaged, he's talking more, he's studying film more. We need him to continue to be good in those.
What did you just Saturday? He really matched with Euros. It was a little difficult the first time, and he shut him down for the most part when he was in.
Yeah, I felt like he was a lot more physical, and he didn't like that he had 20 last game. We definitely reminded him of that. And Oscar takes challenges to heart, and we challenge him at times, and he's good with that.
So, when you look at Damian's progression this season, obviously had so many challenges to start, but what he's evolved to now, and what this could even mean for him going forward next season, just where you think he's grown the most and has the most potential.
Yeah, he's had a really hard road with some personal things off the court. He's really worked hard to get back to where he's supposed to be. And he comes in and works out a lot. And he's a big part of what we can do. I mean, he adds a big element to what we can add with his athleticism and throwing lobs to him and running and just being athletic. But definitely, he for the future is going to be a big part of what we do.
Obviously, Kaysen and Chris have been a huge part of these last two wins. Just how have you seen them take on the extra workload with CJ and Sabir both being out? I know Antonio, after the Georgia game, mentioned that, you know, playing 40 minutes for anyone is tough. You're asking, you know, these guys to play usually 32 plus. How have you seen Kaysen?
I mean, both of those guys have really stepped up into their roles. They're not freshmen anymore. I consider them now, they're sophomores. So they're doing good. And like you say, they're both playing a lot of minutes, especially Kaysen. But Chris has really come along on both ends of the court, doing really well. We're happy for what he's doing and need him to continue to do it. And Kaysen is just he's growing into that leadership role, talking a lot more, speaking up a lot more in practices and timeouts and things like that. So those are both really good players, and we're going to need them down the stretch. And it's really good that they're getting a lot of minutes right now. It's going to help us down the line when we add CJ and Sevier back.
Chris, was there like a light bulb moment where maybe you think it all clicked for him, or from the coaching perspective, just where do you think he could?
I think it was a couple weeks ago. I think we talked about it last time, but he really took it upon himself to pay attention to the details defensively. And when you do that, your game, your offensive game just automatically comes when you really focus on playing hard and doing things and paying attention to the details on the defensive end. Just seeing man and ball, the fundamentals, guarding the basketball, boxing out is a big thing for him. He's doing the little things. That's what I mean by the details.
I think Callie even said on his
Yeah. Like, he's a really, really good offensive rebounder. I think one of the best in the country. And we're on him about going all the time and then boxing out on the other end.
Did you all envision Chris maybe needing some time, some game repetitions to get to this level? Was that something you identified, I guess, earlier in the season that it would be kind of slow
building? Not really, because he's so talented and, you know, he's a really good player. So I didn't anticipate it. But, you know, it's different for different players. And, I mean, it's hard to play as a freshman anywhere in any conference. And we have a couple guys that's freshmen that's playing a lot and playing big roles for us.
After the game on Saturday, Chris mentioned that they kind of heard some of the bubble talk, and he's like, "We knew we needed to win a couple to make sure we're in the tournament." Do you think that was motivating?
We never talk about that. The bubble or the NCAA tournament. I don't know where we're at. We never talk about it with the team. So that's probably something that they did amongst themselves.
Do you think the previews to lose is the new model for the team?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, we say that every day now. And that's something Cal did at UMass. And I remember when I was a kid. And I love it because it's real. It's true. You refuse to lose. You have to have a mentality not to lose games. I'm fine because I'm comfortable with the whole staff. I love our staff. We were just talking about it yesterday after practice, how our whole staff gets along. And, I mean, it's a really good chemistry with our staff. So I stepped right in. It's been just fine with me personally.